We're going to talk about the production of EM waves, electromagnetic waves. For this time, for the first year, there were a few things that were always bothering me about this discussion. I was able to kind of draw the diagrams. I mean, I could draw the diagrams. That wasn't hard. But explaining where they come from exactly was throwing me quite a bit. And John Coley helped me quite a bit to understand Tipler. And I think Knight would, if I had a little bit more time with Knight, he would probably make it a little bit easier as well. So, first of all, the idea of an antenna which uses AC circuits, or uses AC current. So if we start off and we take a conductor and we produce current this direction. So all of a sudden the current is flowing this direction from the bottom up. Okay? One side is, so you can see the current flowing up the antenna. Okay? Well, we know that our electric field goes from positives to negatives, yes? We all in agreement with that? And if that's true, and if the current is going this direction, right, if positive charges are flowing that way, so if our positive charges are moving this way, then that creates a magnetic field around the wire. So our magnetic field would be into the page on that side and out of the page on this side. Do we all agree with that? Okay? Well, at some later point in time, we're going to reverse it. And now, the electric field is going to go this direction. I'll only draw one of them this time. And since our current is flowing downward, the direction positive charges are flowing, then that shows us that we're going to have magnetic field out of the page and magnetic field into the page. Are we all in agreement with that? Now, this is where I really struggled, and John Coley finally helped me. There's like a little bitty sentence he puts at the bottom of his page. It says that these waves continue out and they propagate themselves. But we've always talked about how electric fields start on positives and end on negatives. So why are they continuing out in space if they should end on negative charges? Well, John Coley, and I'm going to read this, it says, we are considering waves traveling through empty space, so there are no charges for lines of electric field to start or stop on, so they form closed loops. Let me see if I can explain that a little bit better. Right here, when we set up an electric field, when we take charges and we put charges, let's imagine that this were not moving, if it were just stationary. If it were stationary, there'd be no magnetic field, would there? Because there's no current. But after a time, we would get electric fields everywhere. They would get weaker as you get farther away, but you would be building up electric fields. They would start the positives and then the negatives. We're all good? But that doesn't just go poof, and there's electric field in all of space. Once you set up this electric field, it'll be here, and then it will slowly go out over time, traveling outward. Does that make sense? So as it's traveling outward this way, this current, which was increasing this direction, causing this electric field to go out, decreases and goes the other direction. Because it's going positive, 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 positive. It's alternating. We follow what I'm doing here? So as you're going like this, and you're driving the positive charges this way, and it causes the electric field to go out, as this electric field is spreading out over space, all of a sudden you move the electric charges the other direction. Well, these electric fields that are going out, well, what do I do? I don't have time to stop on the negative charges. So instead, these ones that are going down, that are way over here, now all of a sudden they're going up. And they form loops. They connect to something, and so they just cause these loops. Okay? Now, let me draw the diagram that everybody draws for EM waves, and then I'm going to show you a little bit that I think will help. So I may have to draw this twice. One because for the discussion later on, but one to kind of explain how it propagates itself. So if we did this again, and we say that there's positives here, negatives here, then this is the direction of the current flow, yes? So this is going to be kind of our legend. So this is going to help us draw that. So the electric field is going down, yes? And the magnetic field is going which way? Into the page. Do we agree with that? So, we can say that if the magnetic field is into the page, the electric field is down. Do we agree with that? Well, then if the electric field is up, the magnetic field is out of the page. Do we agree with that? Yes? Right? So if we need to see it. So now we have positives here, negatives there. The electric field is going up. The current is going down. And the magnetic field is out of the page. We good? So there's our X, Y, and Z axes. If we form a I guess I'll just make it start over here. So if this is our electromagnetic wave, and this is going to be our electric field. Okay, we all good with this? This is our electric field. Now let's look at our legend over here. When the electric field is up, the magnetic field is out of the page. So if this is my z-axis, so I'm going to draw shorter than that. So that's my magnetic field. Likewise over here. And yes, they overlap. And then here, it's going to be into the page. Okay. So, as this is moving, the electric field is going like this. Now, this is over time. Okay, this is a snapshot of where it is. So if we were to take a spot right here, you can imagine that the magnetic field, the field going that direction, the EM wave going that way, would be the same as you moving this way. Does everybody understand what I'm doing there? Right? So if I'm moving this way, it looks like the table is moving behind me. Yes? So if we were to take a point in space right here, as this wave moves past, notice the magnetic field is going to be going in, then the magnetic field is going to be coming out, then in, then out. The magnetic field will be doing this as it passes that point. At the same time, see if I can do this correctly, so it's going to be this. Right? The electric field and magnetic field are going to be alternating as it passes a point. We all good? Now, this next part, which I wish I had another color, and I do not, so I'm going to have to erase this later on. Hopefully this is a decent pen. And it is not. Ooh. Is that kind of like Dr. Lou? Yeah. Okay, so let's look at this point right here where the magnetic field is going into the page, then out of the page. Would you agree that at this point right here, the change of magnetic field is positive if we consider out of the page positive? Yes? Well, if the change of magnetic field goes from negative to positive, then the induced magnetic field must be into the page. Do we agree with that? So B induced is in, which is an X. Agreed? Well, if that's true, then the I induced is, if I'm into the page, clockwise. Yes or no? Yes? Which would look like this. Connecting this wave, this EM, this electric field, with that electric field. And over here, it's going to go the opposite direction. You remember those eddy currents that we saw in the metals? when we took a magnet and you move it across a piece of aluminum, and it causes these eddy currents to go like this. They don't all go one direction, they have to make circles. So likewise, this is making a circle this way, this side is making a circle here. Over here, circles, circles. And this I could not figure out last year, and if you look in the book in John Coley, for us, page 665, he shows this, and he shows the electric fields being connected. Now, one of the ones that I haven't had time to do yet, night, I think if I took the time, night would show how there's a change. Let's see if we can see if I can get lucky here. This is my first time trying this. So here, the electric field is going down. The electric field is changing upwards. Yes? Point my finger this way, and that would cause magnetic fields to go like this. Oh, and those connect. You see them? And likewise down here, going to cause, so likewise, we get these circles. So that the magnetic field changes, which causes the electric field. The electric field changes, which causes the magnetic field change. Even though we started all this with an antenna, with charges going back and forth. Once they spread out and they start to connect to themselves, one causes the other, which causes the other, which causes the other, which makes this a self-propagating field. Now let me clean up my diagram here a little bit. That makes sense how that works? Okay. And again, for those of us that have night, that's on page 1062. Go ahead and clean this up a little bit because we're going to not want to use that. Was that 1062 in night? At least for me, that makes me feel good about, they talk about this EM wave will self, you know, will continue traveling through space, and that makes me feel better as to why. Okay? Okay, that's clean enough. All right, now, we have over here that a changing electric field causes a magnetic field, and a changing magnetic field causes an electric field. And in both of these cases, we take a closed loop. And we find over here we have the electric field, ddt, the change of that over time, and the change over time. So we're going to make two, and this is where I'm sure that the actual method of doing this is harder than this, but this is a simple derivation that works. So we're going to take a loop here, and we're going to make a loop that comes this direction. So this is in the XZ plane, okay? So it's this direction, okay? Not very good. Let me see if I draw that a little bit better. So yeah, that's a little bit better, yes? So that's in the XZ plane, and you see how the electric field is going to enter it. You see how the electric field is going to go like this into that plane? Yes?
Yeah.
So the electric flux in that plane is going to increase. Well, we're going to take another one, and since this is going, moving in the Z direction, we're going to make a plane here, which is in the XY plane. And in this case, the magnetic field is going to go in and out at that point. Yes? Good. So first of all, let's do this XY plane over here. And I've got enough room way over here to do this, so. In the XY plane, because you have a magnetic field entering, don't we know we're going to get an EMF? There's a changing magnetic field, you get an EMF. Okay? So we know that our EMF will equal d phi dt, which will also, as we see over there, equal E dl. And what is this d phi dt? Well, that's the magnetic field times the area. Yes? This is a closed loop here. Okay? We all good on that? Well, we're using that one in the xy plane, so let's just make sure. In the xy plane, as this magnetic field is entering, okay, would you agree that this direction, the x amount, the flux is increasing once it enters, that this right here, the x component is increasing. The amount of flux in the x direction is increasing. The amount of flux in this direction is not changing. Okay? So if we put that together, and I'll deal with this in a little bit. The magnetic field is constant. It's actually changing over time, but this makes the derivation a lot easier. Okay, that's the, in parentheses, we're simplifying things, as if you're shooting a projectile and there's no air resistance. Okay? We get the right answer, but this is the part that I also kind of go, but I don't think I want to do this without it, because it would probably be terrible. So I take the magnetic field out. So now it's just dt of the xy plane. Which one is changing? X is increasing because it's moving that direction. Well, that gives me by dx dt. And what is dx dt? That's the velocity in the x direction. We got to figure out what to do with this. This talks not about the magnetic field. This talks about the electric field around that closed loop. Well, here's my closed loop going like this. I have an electric field. Why is that one going up? I have no idea. So, I have an electric field going this direction, yes? Okay, it's going down. So imagine this, I'm sorry, imagine this is right here. I had to draw it up a little bit, okay? So it's right here. And you see that right here, we get an electric field that's parallel. Here's dl here, but the electric field is perpendicular. So that equals zero. The electric field hasn't reached here yet, so that's zero, so all of this becomes E times Y. Once again, E is going this direction, which is parallel to that DL. Perpendicular to this DL equals zero. Perpendicular to this DL, zero. No E at this point yet. Yes? So, if I bring this down, I was going to do this in blue, just to keep the two loops constant. So I get E times Y equals BY times VX. And I get that VX equals E over B. And I'm going to do that. That's a big deal. We good there? So now let's look at our other plane here, using the exact same idea. Now we have do we have any current flowing through there? Do we have an actual conduction current in a wire? No. All we have is a changing electric field, and we're going to do the exact same thing that we did before. So now, using Ampere's displacement current, we're going to get B dot, and here we go. Well, let's just write it out, I guess. So equals mu naught, E naught, was it ddt? Of E dA. Well, let's look at this around the closed loop. So if we look here, you see how the magnetic field is going this direction? It has not reached this one yet, has it? So that equals zero. It's here, your DLs. So remember, here's DL, 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 DL. Now, in this case, there's a negative. We're going to ignore that, okay? So you see how it's parallel to this one, perpendicular to these two, and not even at that point yet. And what is this dimension? This is which plane?
Z.
It's actually Z. So here, we're going to get B times Z equals mu naught, epsilon naught, take out the electric field. And what are we going to get here? This breaks into xz. Z comes out because what's actually changing as this electric field is moving in? The x direction is changing, isn't it? So that just, once again, gives me dx dt, which is just the velocity in the x direction once again. Now, I do not expect you to follow this the first time, but if this not so bad, I put this online, you could look at this again if you so wanted. So notice the z's cancel again. And this time I get vx equals, double check I get the, I'm not going to do that. I want to solve for e over b in this case. Okay? So let's solve for e over b. So e over b, notice the z's cancel. So I get, is it 1 over all that junk? I think I did that right, yes? I wanted to do this in red, but oh well, I'm messing up on my colors a little bit. I'm going to take this and that, and I'm going to combine them. And I'll do it right here so that. So we get Vx equals 1 over that. We all in agreement with that? I'm going to solve for Vx. Still all good? Yes? And we get Vx equals 1 over the square root of mu naught epsilon naught. And let's go ahead and put in some numbers, shall we? Get out your calculators, please. So we get 4 pi. Times 10 to the minus 7 times 8.85 times 10 to the minus 12. No one yell out the answer. Make sure everybody gets it on their own. Take the square root and inverse it. Everybody do that, please, on their own. Get a big old number, which is this. 2. There's 3 nines. Well, and again, this depends on how well you round some of this stuff. And there's a bunch of other junk here, okay? It actually turns out it rounds to 3 times 10 to the 8 meters per second, which is, of course, the speed of light. Which, when Maxwell did this, he realized that the electromagnetic waves created by an alternating, by an antenna, would propagate outwards, would self-propagate outwards at the speed of light. Wow. And later on, this was actually produced by, this was actually produced by a gentleman named Hertz. And he was able to make radio waves using alternating current in an antenna, which again, propagated outwards at the speed of light and proved that those waves were actually light waves.